MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's game one of the National League Division Series between the Colorado Rockies and the Milwaukee Brewers. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian welcoming you to our exclusive postseason coverage on MLB Network. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, we'll start with you. This series has the feel of one that's about to get very interesting.
Well, here's a little comparison of these two teams. Looking at it earlier, to me, the story is all about the pitching. Both squads have some good arms, and the team that gets the best outings are probably going to come out on top.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Back now live as we count down to the start of game one. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now, your 2018 Milwaukee Brewers.
Briefly now, we'll look at the two starters who get the ball here in game one. And a moment now to peek at the Rockies starting lineup. Who are you focused on, Dan Plesac?
Well, I'm looking for a big performance from Nolan Arenado. He's coming off a five-hit game. His confidence is soaring. You can see it how he walks. He's got that swagger going. When he gets in the box, he's got that chest puffed out a little bit more. I love watching this guy go about his business.
Gio Gonzalez will do the pitching in front of the hometown crowd here in game one. Dan, any thoughts?
Gio Gonzalez, quality lefty. First thing you think of when you think of Gio, that big overhand curveball. Might be one of the best curveballs in baseball. Pretty good fastball, too. 92 to 93 miles an hour. That big overhand hook and a straight changeup. Really quality pitcher.
All right, guys, here's a defensive alignment for the Milwaukee Brewers. And let's take a look at Travis Shaw. The calling card's the bat. Left-handed power, the ability to manipulate both gaps, but also a very adequate, very underrated defender on both corners, both first and third.
Leading off the afternoon for Colorado, second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
Pitch on the way. And we are underway this afternoon as the first pitch is over for a called strike one. Now the pitch. A wave and a miss. Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2. Count remains at 0-2. One and two to DJ LeMahieu. Our temperature here this afternoon creeping up to the 60-degree mark here at first pitch. Ready on 1-2. Popped him up. And he'll put this one away for the first down of the inning.
Batting second, center fielder, Charlie Blackmon.
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Low for ball one. And there is our officiating crew in this one, calling balls and strikes, Mr. Freddie Ferguson.
You know, this is one of the guys behind the dish, Freddie Ferguson, Dan, that the rookies are going to have a tough time with. If you've played in the league for a little bit, you understand that he's got his own zone.
You touched on it, D-Roy. I think he rewards the veteran players, not only pitchers, but position players. He makes the younger players, he makes them earn their keep.
And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
Third baseman, Nolan Arenado.
Here's Nolan Arenado in head-to-head meetings with Gio Gonzalez. He's just 2 for 12. He also has one home run. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. 0-1 the count. Arenado has a history in coming through in the clutch moments, of course. It's always a little bit of a debate whether or not being clutch is actually a trait that a player possesses. But with him, there's no denying it. We've seen him deliver in big moments repeatedly throughout his career. It just seems he elevates his game somehow when the pressure is on.
Yeah, Matty, he has definitely put that debate to rest. He has absolute ice water in his veins.
And a fastball swung on and missed, and his side is retired. Three up, three down for Colorado. Now it's the Brew Crew's turn in a scoreless ball game. Time now for a look at the hometown Brewers starting lineup. Mark, daytime baseball at home. What do we need to know about these guys?
Matty, the key in this one for this lineup is they got to stay staunch in the middle of the plate. They can't start swinging at everything, or this guy will abuse them. He'll start flipping up the rosin bag. They have to sit over those 17 inches and hold to that.
German Marquez gets the call in hostile territory here for game one of the division series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, we're getting a chance to look at a guy that is a little bit up and down throughout points of his career. A career ERA just over 4. When he's good, he can be really good. And when he's bad, well, let's just say he can be pretty bad at times. But it'll be interesting to see which one we see. He's a little bit of Jekyll and Hyde. Hopefully he's going to be a little bit more Jekyll than Hyde in this one here today.
Here now is the center fielder Lorenzo Cain to get us started in the bottom half of the first.
Center fielder Lorenzo Cain.
Here comes the first pitch. And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one. Chopped weakly to the left. Gonna be a tough play. And there's one away.
Adding second, the shortstop, Orlando Arcia.
Digging in, Orlando Arcia. First pitch on its way. Fouled off. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And you wonder about the control now as he misses high with a slider.
I'm pretty surprised by the location on those last three pitches. The book on him is that he hits the way pitch pretty well, and he just saw three in a row out there.
So does he go back out there again?
No, Matt, I expect him to mix it up. Most catchers won't call from the same location over and over and over.
And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away. And with two away now, let's give you a look at the big picture here. There you see the participants in this year's playoffs. In is Christian Yelich. Previous history with German Marquez. He's just 2 for 9. first pitch of the at-bat. And he tries to hold back on the swing, but I think it would have been ruled a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Two out, nobody on. And a fastball swung on and hit to second. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Second inning straight ahead here at Miller Park with no score. So next it'll be the number four batter for the Rockies, Trevor Story. He'll look to get something going here in this scoreless ball game.
MVP! MVP!
First offering on its way. And that one stayed too low apparently. Takes a high fastball for a strike.
That's ball.
Missed with a breaking ball.
You got two balls, one strike.
Now the 2-1. High in the air down the right field line. And foul. The 2-2 is in there, a called strike three.
Flat out locked him up with the changeup right there. Usually you're trying for a swing and miss when you throw that pitch in a two strike count, but clearly he wasn't looking for it, so it's a backwards K for him.
In now for Colorado, Ian Desmond, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. A high fastball is in there. Oh, he was fooled that time on the pitch away as he went around for strike two. Pitch on the way. Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. And the throw is made to record the second out of the inning.
Hate to be Captain Obvious here, but he looks great to begin this start. That's already three Ks for him in the first five hitters. It'd be awesome to see him keep up this pace.
Standing in, David Dahl. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. First delivery to him on the way. Another slow breaking ball that misses down low. And the changeup is way low that time. The 2-0. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Yelich is under it, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Rockies. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Jesus Aguilar. He'll start things out here in a tie ball game.
Aguilar.
First pitch coming. Here it is. And he takes a pitch right down the middle. Now the 0-1. Missed with a slider. fastball, not close. It's 2-1 now. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2. Line drive to center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So the Brewers get their leadoff man aboard to start out the frame.
No mistake what he was sitting on, looking for a dead red piece of cheese middle of the plate, and he didn't miss it.
Stepping into the box, Travis Shaw. First pitch coming, here it is. And that pitch catches the inside corner. Aguilar gets his lead at first, nobody out. Breaking ball, that's in the dirt as he takes a ball. Now a fastball as he has to lean out of the way there.
When in doubt, take a step off the mound, grab the rosin bag, and take a deep breath. After a leadoff single, now you almost drilled the guy with the next pitch. You have to find a way to rely on your mechanics.
The 2-1 home is taken for strike two. The 2-2 is laid off, and the count runs full. Misses there for ball four, so runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
Always tough to issue a free pass, but especially troublesome when you give up a single right before that to start the inning. We'll see if he can figure out a way to wiggle out of this.
Here's Jonathan Schoop now. Set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Now a check swing, but it's strike one anyway, says the home plate umpire.
I heard so many pitchers in my career in the dugout talk about you're only one pitch away from getting out of a nasty situation. This is perfect right here. A strikeout or a double play, and he can get right back in control of this inning.
One and one. None out, runners at first and second. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1.
Back-to-back sliders away. Now I think you have to think about running something hard in. Not a good idea to throw a good hitter the same pitch three times in a row.
The 3-1. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
We knew coming into this game that this guy has a tendency to give up a lot of free passes, and history repeats itself as he's already given up two walks here. I'll tell you, effectively wild is a pretty tough thing to be.
Now at the plate, Manny Pena. He'll get to take his first cuts here. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Very weakly on the ground.
The pitcher has to find a way to minimize damage here. Maybe take two outs for one run. Who cares? Get a double play, pop up, strikeout. Something to get you back in this inning.
And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Bases loaded here, nobody out.
D-Rex.
1-2. With two strikes now and a runner at first, do you go for the strikeout or are you still looking for the double play ball?
Well, Matt, I think a lot of that depends on the type of pitcher that you are. If you're a power pitcher, you can go ahead and ride a fastball up in the zone. But if you're a guy that induces a lot of ground balls with a sinker, I think you have to stick with that plan.
Still 1-2. Needs a punch out here. Can he get it? Not on that one as it's fouled away and the count holds at 1-2. Not just yet. It's ball two. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Count remains full. The next 3-2. Oh, and it misses, ball four, and that will force home a run.
Well, he's really laboring in the early going here. That's his third walk of the game already. We'll see if he can get it together or if this is just one of those days where he's going to have to grind his way through this start.
Here's Ryan Braun now. Here it comes. And a curveball that started low and broke lower. Ball one. Tight spot. Bases loaded. Nobody out. Up top, it's 2-0.
Putting himself in a pretty bad situation now on 2-0 and the bases loaded. He basically doesn't have much of an option but to challenge him right here.
Now the 2-0. And this ball's pretty well struck high and deep to left field. Dunk. Going back at the track. A leap, but he can't get it. It's off the wall. Oh, and the throw back in is a wild one. Tag, and they get him at the plate as one run scores, but not the second.
Batting ninth,
Next to hit will be the pitcher, Gio Gonzalez. And he may instead be asked to bunt. We'll see how they approach the situation with one away. First pitch on its way. Now a bunt attempt here. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Coming up now on 30 pitches in the inning. And the pitcher will indeed try and move his runners as he gets this one down. And you can't ask for much more out of a pitcher than that. The sacrifice works to perfection.
The center fielder number 6, Lorenzo Cain.
In now is Lorenzo Cain. From the stretch, here's the pitch. There's a fastball right over the inside corner.
You know, I think this is a big situation in this game. They've got to lead by a couple of runs, but they don't want to look back on this inning when this one's over and think that they left some runs out there on the base path. Scoring more here would be huge.
Strike 2 on the curveball. 0-2.
A strike away now from getting out of this mess. Sometimes pitching is all about minimizing, right? So keeping it to 2 runs across in the inning would be huge.
Pena, the runner at third. Braun on at second with 2 down. Now a curveball ripped down the left field line. That's a fair ball. As he arrives at second without a play, as they also score a pair of runs on the play.
When this one left the bat, the pitcher was hoping and praying it would go foul, and I thought it might, but it ends up falling just inches inside the line, going for a double and driving in 2.
Next to bat, Orlando Arcia, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike 1. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. In the dirt here. Good job keeping it close as the count goes to 1-1. Now the 1-1 pitch is strike 2 swinging.
I know that fastball registered at about 92, 93, but I guarantee you it looked about 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than that for this offensive player. After coming off a curveball, the old push the throttle and pull it is being used.
A little bouncer. Four runs here in this half inning. Nope. And a good take there will push it to 2-2 now on the Brewers shortstop.
He certainly has an open base down there, but you don't want your defender standing flat-footed for much longer.
Runner, yes,
and
yes.
Now the runner's trying for third. There's a swing and a high pop-up. Story waits on it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. So they nearly bat around here as 8 men come to the plate, and they push across 4 runs. We played 2 full. The Brewers lead it 4-0. One of the landmarks here in Milwaukee, the North Point Water Tower. Welcome back to Miller Park. Here's the catcher now, Chris Iannetta. He's the number 7 hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first 6 guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
Our house, baby. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Takes a knee-high fastball.
I mean, the obvious key right now is the movement on his two-seamer. He's able to spot it up in when he has to, and he's able to go backdoor.
The 0-1 on its way. And that one just missed outside. Way in front of that fastball. And it's fouled away. This is on the ground over to first. Aguilar loves it, and he'll step on first himself for the out.
Had to protect there with two strikes, and he just got it off the end of the bat. Not much of a problem for the infield at that point.
Here's Cargo, Carlos Gonzalez, as he'll lay off a curveball in the dirt for ball one. Ball two. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0.
You know, when you haven't gotten a guy on base yet in the entire game, a three-ball count kind of feels like a little mini rally. Let's see if he can get on.
One out, nobody on. Gonzalez able to lay off, and he's aboard after working a base on balls.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
So here now is the pitcher, Herman Marquez. He could be bunting here in order to stay out of the double play. First pitch of the at bat on its way. And this one gets away. And forget about the double play now, as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, when you throw a breaking ball in the dirt, that's the danger. You have to trust your catcher, but this one skips away, and the open base takes the double opportunity away with it. Might prove to be costly.
Don't let him score. The 1-0 is looked at for the first strike.
1-1.
The 1-1 home. Makes him swing and miss on a ball out of the zone for strike two.
Wow, that changeup is an absolute beaut. They call it the great equalizer for a reason.
The 1-2. And this is fouled at the plate. Misses 2-2.
Well, these are just extra pitches that are just going to add to your pitch count. He's not trying to work around him, and no reason to, but sometimes you just lose the strike zone for no apparent reason.
Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Now, I know he struck out there, but for a pitcher, that's a pretty solid at bat. Anytime you can make an opposing pitcher out there work and throw quite a few more extra pitches,
That's a quality AB in my book.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu, runner in scoring position with two gone. From the belt, kicks and deals. He'll start him with a fastball down and in for a ball, 1-0. Gonzalez at second with two down. A ball and a strike to Colorado's leadoff batter. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire. Ball two. Popped him up. Aguilar moving to his left, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. One left for Colorado. They trail here 4-0. With Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian with you as the left-handed hitting Christian Yelich settles in to start out the inning. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. The windup and the 0-1. And there's one well above the zone for a ball. So 1-1 home. In the air now out to left field. Waiting on it is Dahl. One out.
The batter, first baseman, Jesus Aguilar.
Striding forward now, the Brewers cleanup hitter, Jesus Aguilar. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. There's a fastball that just misses. Ball one. That's wide, 2-0.
Not the ideal spot to be right here. 2-0 count on a real good hitter. Boy, you're going to have to make some really good pitches now.
The 2-0. 3-0 now.
I wouldn't be surprised if he had the green light here. Matter of fact, I know he's got the green light here. He's looking for something set or cut, and he's looking to do damage.
The 3-0. Finds the zone, strike one. The 3-1 pitch. There's ball four.
Up next for Milwaukee, third baseman, Travis.
Digging in, Travis Shaw. He scored after reaching on a walk in his first at-bat. From the stretch, Nope. And that misses ball one.
I wonder if that call not going his way right there has anything to do with walking the last guy. We all know umpires don't give you much on the corners if you're not throwing strikes consistently.
The 1-0 home count, now a ball and a strike. Runner at first here, one man out. Two and one.
Boy, the curveball just hasn't been there this afternoon, and this guy's bread and butter pitch, especially when he gets ahead of hitters. He needs to find that curveball again.
Set, and the 2-1 pitch fouled away. Here now the 2-2. Count remains 2-2. Runners on first with one down. Lazy fly ball out to center field. LeMahieu into shallow center, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
Into the box, Jonathan Schoop. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. Reached base via the walk in his first plate appearance. One oh count. Here it is. Two balls and no strikes.
They obviously circled him before the game that they were not going to let him beat them. Walked him this first time up, and now they're nibbling again.
A runner on first with two away.
Let's go, Brewers! Come on!
Grounded down the third baseline, but this will get fouled. 2-1. Lifted in the air to straightaway center. Blackman is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Brewers strand one. They lead it 4-0. Here's Charlie Blackman now.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on, but you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle, and one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
But an Adam ball right to him for the first down.
Third baseman Nolan Arenado.
Striding in once again, Nolan Arenado. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. First pitch of the at bat on its way, and this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one.
Hey.
A ball and a strike. No runs, no hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Rockies thus far. Two balls, two strikes to Nolan Arenado.
Well, one thing about him, he's an absolute grinder at the plate. You can pretty much count on him battling at the plate every chance he gets.
He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
I'll tell you, he looks really dialed in on the bump right there. He's got a shutout going, and he really seems to have this lineup off balance. Even when he challenges them up in the zone, they don't have an answer for it.
And that brings in the power-hitting shortstop, Trevor Story. This guy's still looking at a zero in the hit column. Here's the first pitch to him. Lofted in the air out toward right center. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Colorado. They're down 4-0. Next for Milwaukee, Manny Pena will start it out here for Milwaukee with Ryan Braun waiting on deck to follow.
Even though they're up by a boatload early on in this one, you can't get complacent and get lazy. They got to keep the gas pedal down because this team that they're playing can strike and score a lot of runs too.
And here's a called strike at the knees. Don't think he liked that one too much, but it's 0-1. Now the pitch.
Zero.
A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
He's attacking this hitter a lot more aggressively than he did the first time when he faced him and issued a walk, coming right after him here.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's 1-2.
Tried to get him to chase that 0-2 curveball there, but he wasn't biting. Very well could see it again here, though.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. A fastball that just misses inside. Fly ball right down the line and left. Waiting on it is Dahl. One out.
The right fielder, number 8, Ryan Braun.
Ready now, Ryan Braun, looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at bat. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. There's a strike. Swung on and missed, outclassed by that fastball for a strike.
Two mid-90s fastballs and you're down 0-2. This is where you got to take a deep breath and pop commit. You're either all in on another fastball or you're finding a way to stay back to attack something off speed.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Another 0-2 home.
Nope,
the 0-2 is a breaking pitch taken for a ball, 1-2. Four runs, only three hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
He went with the off-speed there once he got him to 0-2, but now that they both missed, I think we'll see more of a challenge pitch here. You don't have to give in, but you can't be too cute either.
The 2-2. Is looked at and the count moves full.
That was another good pitch and a tough call that could have gone either way. He couldn't get him to bite on it again, so the count's gone from 0-2 to 3-2.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. Another Another full count pitch home. And another foul ball. Making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at bat coming up. Hit hard on the ground to second. Gloved by LeMahieu. Throw gets Braun at first as he grounds out for out number two.
Good range shown off into the hole right there. That's not an easy play, but these guys make it look that way sometimes.
In now, Gio Gonzalez. As he will take strike one on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. He did his job and laid down the successful sack bunt in his first appearance. And this is high, a ball and a strike. Swing and a line drive. Foul. The 1-2. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. LeMahieu's got it. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. So they go quietly here in this half inning. On to the top of inning number five we go. It's the Brewers 4 and the Rockies nothing.
Leading out for Colorado, first baseman, Ian Desmond.
Go back to Colorado.
Here comes the first pitch. A fastball down near the shoe tops. Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two.
As a pitcher, you got to feel good that you had him out front. Even though he didn't pot commit on that one, it opens up a lot of weapons for you to go high fastball or throw even a better off-speed pitch.
Check swing grounder to the right side. And they'll just tag him out along the first base line.
Sometimes for a first baseman, the best thing you do is just go ahead and tag the guy like that. Hey, there's a lot more that can go wrong when you try to throw to the pitcher or the second baseman covering.
Stepping in, David Dahl. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Changeup in for a strike.
Hey, it's not always about filling up the strike zone all the time every inning. He's pitching well as we're moving into the middle innings, but interestingly, less than 50% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. Two and one to David Dahl. The 2-1. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Kane is under it, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Still a little early to start talking about these things. There you go, right there. A big goose egg in that hit column, worth keeping in mind as we get later into the afternoon. Here's the catcher now, Chris Iannetta, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. First pitch coming, here it is. A ball and no strikes.
All bets are off for the offense right now. This guy's got a low pitch count. He's attacking the zone. They have to get more aggressive. This guy's not going anywhere.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's the 1-1 delivery. And a neck-high fastball that time. This is hit out to right. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. 8 in a row he's set down, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Rockies. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. In now is Lorenzo Cain. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point.
Lorenzo Cain.
Here comes the first pitch. And he'll look at a first pitch curveball that's in the dirt. It's ball one.
Well, he's still out there to start the fifth inning, but it's been a real grind of a start for him. The pitch count is much higher than he'd like it to be, so it's hard to imagine him working really deep into this game.
A 1-1 count to the Brewers' leadoff man. Action now in that Colorado pen as a southpaw has stood up to throw out there. Hit on the ground out to short. Story brings it in, and that's the first out.
The batter number 3, shortstop, Orlando Arcia.
Next to bat, Orlando Arcia. First offering on its way. And that one just missed outside. Line drive to left. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit. The throw into second. And he is in there.
Just goes to show, if you're going to throw that two-seam fastball away, which I don't think is the best pitch anyway, you better start that thing out of the zone and let it work its way back to the corner. With this one, it started out on the corner, so it leaked back right over the heart of the plate and got whacked.
Chris Russell, a 6'2" left-hander, jogs in to take over on the hill. In is Christian Yelich. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing and one. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Fouled off. Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2. Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit. 1-2. Arcia leads off second with one gone in the inning. And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number 2.
For me, check swings are right there next to bang-bang plays at first, as the most difficult calls for an ump to make. Taking a look at show motion, the batter doesn't appear to hold up enough, so I think the call was right.
Standing in now, Jesus Aguilar. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Two out here and a runner at second. One and one, the count to the Brewers first baseman. The 1-1 pitch. Here's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. In the dirt, and now let's see. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch.
That can be a tough read as a runner on second to see if the ball has gotten away enough to move to third. You have to be sure you can make it. He was there, and now he's only 90 feet away.
Men on third with two down. Sharp ground ball to third. Arenado has it. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Milwaukee leaves one, but they're in front 4-0. Coming to the plate now, Carlos Gonzalez. He drew a base on balls his first time up.
We're moving through the middle of this ball game right now. They want to get things going. How about trying to get some base runners on, or at least get a base hit? They don't have any hits going into this part of the game.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss just behind a lively fastball. Swing and a hard liner to center field. Kane, patrolling center, makes the play, one out.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
Number one will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Looked inside, but that's ruled a strike. Nothing in one. Bases are empty. One man out. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. So 1-1. Is laid off for ball two. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
And there's a called strike at the knees as he was hoping for a base on balls there, but it's a full count now, 3-2. Hit back up the middle. And there's the first hit of the game for Colorado.
Wow, I was starting to wonder if we had to go on no-hit alert, Dan. I know you were privy to that. Sixth inning right here, they finally break through with their first hit of the game.
And you have to wonder, D-Ro, this guy had been cruising all along going into this sixth inning. We'll see if he can be able to buckle down right here. The sixth and seventh innings are normally the toughest inning for a starting pitcher, so we'll see if he can minimize the damage now.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. A high fastball is in there.
You know, you look at this hitter, he doesn't care about being down 0-1. He doesn't care about having two strikes with him. He's got the utmost confidence in his ability to work back into the count and get him something over the heart of the plate.
Let's go. He's
runner
going,
he's goes going. For second. Pitch inside, the throw. And it skips in as he steals the bag easily.
Looked to me like they anticipated him trying to swipe that bag. I mean, the pitcher shortened his delivery to the plate, but it didn't make a difference in the slightest. He still swiped that bag.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Missed with a breaking ball. Runner at second here with one man out. A line shot to third base, but the runner is back to avoid the double play.
Now batting, the center fielder, Charlie Blackmon.
Here's Charlie Blackmon now. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. First pitch of the at bat. There's a strike.
0-1's the count.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
You know, he's one of their guys they rely on to get their offense going. They need a rally, so we'll see if he can spark one here.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. So they do get their first hit, but their first run will have to wait as the inning is over. Rockies strand one. They trail here 4-0. Scott Ober enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 45, Scott Ober.
Standing in, Travis Shaw, 0-for-1 with a run scored thus far.
Third baseman, Travis Shaw.
Here comes the first pitch. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. Try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Popped him up. Iannetta shading to his right, one down.
The batter, number 5, second baseman, Jonathan.
Ready once again, Jonathan Schoop. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. He's set and the pitch. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. And that Colorado bullpen comes to life now with a lefty and a right-hander up to throw. Oh and one, here it comes. Slider's in for a strike.
0-2 is the count.
Missed with a slider. One out, nobody on.
Come on, Blue Crew.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time. Out number two.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
Into the box now, Manny Pena, as he rips it on the ground to second. LeMahieu's got it. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Gone in order are the Brewers, but they hold a 4-0 lead. Back here at Miller Park in Milwaukee. Seventh inning coming up now in game one as we take a look there at our game summary through the first six innings so far. Here's Nolan Arenado, and he's likely just trying to put one in play here. 0-for-2 with a pair of strikeouts thus far.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. And a fastball just a bit up.
We've seen him go down on strikes more than once in this game, so this has been a better approach by him at this at bat. Much more patient, and he's gotten himself into a good hitter's count.
Hot shot on the ground is short, and that's through into left. So a leadoff single here to start the seventh.
Hey, they say in this game you better have a short memory. Well, that's obviously the case with this batter. He came into that third at bat after getting his ticket punched twice and was able to get a single.
And that brings in the power hitting shortstop Trevor Story as he lifts it in the air to right field. And this is taken out there by Braun for the first out.
Now batting, first baseman, Ian Desmond.
MVP, MVP!
So stepping in, Ian Desmond. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Popped him up. And no one will get this one. Arenado leads off first with one away. Oh, and this at bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0-2 now.
You see that swing right there? You know what that tells me, boys? That this pitcher is doing his job right here, but also the offense is obviously not picking anything up today.
Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes. Hit the other way out toward right field. And Braun will handle this one for out number two.
Up next for Colorado, left fielder David Dahl.
And that'll bring up the speedy outfielder David Dahl. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one.
Get out of here, Rocky!
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Breaking ball just misses the inside corner.
That's a tough pitch to throw right there. That front door curveball just missed hitting that inside corner. That's a very difficult pitch. I'm not sure if he wanted to get that one down and away, and unfortunately that one stayed inside.
1-0 count. Here it is. Takes a knee-high fastball.
You know, they finally get the leadoff runner on. It would be sad to watch him waste this opportunity. Somebody's got to come through with a base hit.
The 1-1 is a fastball down below the knees. Hard hit ball to second, and that's through for a hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Hey, this might be their best opportunity to at least get on the board. They've been struggling offensively, and they find themselves with two runners on board. Let's see if they can continue it.
Into the box, Chris Iannetta. As he'll take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0. No hits to this point.
Boy, he better get it back together here quick because he's got two guys on already. He's starting to lose location of that strike zone. He's got to throw a strike right here.
Two men are on with two men out. Takes a high fastball for a strike. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. The 2-1. The count now at 2-2. Here now the 2-2. He stays alive, still 2-2. Still even at 2-2. Two down, runners at first and second. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. On the eighth pitch of the at bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Two left for Colorado. They're down 4-0. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Brian Shaw will come on now and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Tony Walters will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. Here's Brian Braun now. His numbers against Brian Shaw, he's gone 2-for-8.
Leading off for the Brewers, the right fielder number 8, Brian Braun.
First pitch of the at bat on its way, and a fastball just a bit high. Shaw, a 6'1" right-hander, he was taken in the second round during the 2008 draft.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on a superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go into high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has. Nice pick.
A ball and a strike now. Swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2. And the slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2.
I think if he executes that pitch on the corner instead of off of it, he probably gets some pretty weak contact, if anything. He jammed him pretty hard on the previous pitch, so my bet was he was going to try to cheat on the inside part, thinking it might be coming again.
Oh, and he took a big swing at that one as this is driven out to deep left center field. And it is trouble that finds the gap for extra bases. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Talk about starting off the inning with a bang. Goodness. When this thing left the bat, I thought it was out of here. And I think he might have, too. Only made it to the warning track, but he glides into second base with a leadoff double.
Digging in once again, Gio Gonzalez. He's been great on the mound, so we'll see if he can do something with the bat here as well. He's earned a chance to take this at bat.
Yeah, Matt, when a guy's throwing the ball as well as he has, it kind of forces the manager's hand to stay with him. He's been exciting to watch, and he's really had this crowd behind him the entire game.
Here's the first pitch to him. Now a bunt attempt here, and a good decision there to sweep this away in foul territory and make him try it again. Now a bunt attempt here. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice.
Well, when you're trying to move a guy up to third with a bunt, that's exactly how you want to do it. Make the third baseman field the ball. That way, his only play is to first. That was very well executed.
Stepping in now, Lorenzo Cain, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. A couple of RBIs for him already, and a chance for more here. The 1-0 home misses ball two.
Great situation to be up at the plate right now, but if you're on the mound, there is absolutely no reason to give in to him. Stay on the outer quadrants of the plate and don't get beat in the middle.
Here's a swing and a miss on the cut fastball, 2-1. Braun stands at third with one gone in the inning. Hit in the air down the right field line. Gonzalez on the run. But he won't get it. And now it jumps the wall for a ground rule double.
I mean, that had to feel good right there, Dan. That's his third RBI of the game and extends his team's lead. They might have this one locked up.
Well, I tell you, those are always big, those add-on insurance runs. Big RBI right there for a little bit more breathing room.
In now, Orlando Arcia, as he takes a cold strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2.
No balls, two strikes. Hey, two pitches at the knees right now, and you're down 0-2. This is where you got to fight. I want to see a two-strike approach. Maybe a little choke up. Maybe a little fight up the middle the other way. Grind back into this count.
Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Desmond is there to put it away for out number two.
The left fielder, number 22, Christian.
Now in the box, Yelich. Christian Yelich. Not providing much out of the three hole in this one. Hitless in three at-bats so far. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Just a tick behind for a strike.
They've done a real nice job keeping this guy into wraps in this one. No hits for him so far, and what stands out to me is they're going right after him. They're not pitching him like they're afraid he's going to do any damage.
Behind 0-2 now. has a look. Now the pitch. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes. Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's one and two.
I like that he tried to tie him up inside on that pitch, but it was a little bit of a risky situation because if you're off just a little bit, you can end up plunking a guy. That's the last thing you want to do when you've got a guy 0-2.
The 1-2. This is lined to left, and that's in there. Base hit. Keane rounds the corner and is headed home. And now, gracious, just getting the ball back into the infield is becoming a problem.
Hey, with two strikes right there, he's trying to run that ball up and in to try to tie him up, but it didn't quite work out.
Yeah, in today's game, everybody's fighting so hard to keep their hands inside the baseball that I think a non-executed pitch on the inner half, Dan, is exactly what the batter's looking for, something he can keep his hands inside and just fist to the opposite field.
He's set. Here it comes. And that one stayed too low, apparently. Two out here and a runner at second. Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
This inning really feels like it's getting away from him out there. As a reliever, you can't let that happen. Nothing you can do about what's already happened, and it's only going to get worse if you're not focusing on the guy in the batter's box.
Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Come on, Brewers.
3-0 pitch is a swinging strike.
He came out of his shoes on that one, boys. I know he swung and missed it. We felt the breeze from up here, but if he gets that pitch again and catches it a grain low, we got action.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And that misses, ball four. So it's first and second now with two out. So that's the second walk he's worked in this one.
Yeah, and that seems to be a popular approach when this guy steps in. He can really hurt you with one swing. So I think the idea is mostly not to let this one guy beat you, Matt.
Now pitching for the Rockies.
So they'll go to the bullpen now, and it'll be the left-hander here to face the upcoming left-handed batter. And that brings up the left-handed hitting Travis Shaw as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. His individual history against Jake McGee, he's just 1-for-6. One and one the count now. Now the 1-1 pitch is a slider that misses below the zone. Two men are on with two men out. To 2-2 now. McGee's ready. 2-2 pitch on its way. And a big strikeout there as they'll leave a couple of runners on base. And after a good start to the inning, they can't capitalize any further. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and two left. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. Brewers are out in front, 6-0. Here's Cargo, Carlos Gonzalez. He leads off their half of the 8th, and they've been unable to get that starter out of the game to this point.
Yeah, he settled in early on the mound, partly due to the lead his guys gave him to take some of the pressure off. He's taken that and pitched very effectively in this one.
First pitch coming. Here it is.
Swing.
There's a fastball that just misses. Ball one. Action in that Milwaukee bullpen now as a left-hander started to throw out there. And he comes back with one in there for a high strike. Two balls and a strike to Carlos Gonzalez. Two balls and two strikes now. The 2-2. High in the air out to center field. Kane will wait on it. One gone. Eighth inning from Milwaukee with the Brewers out on top in this one as you get a look there at the line score and how we got to this point. Digging in, Tony Walters. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. First pitch on its way. A fastball that just misses inside. Bases are empty, one man out. And he misses low with it, 2-0.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
And he gets this fastball over. It's 2-1. The 2-1 home. Waves and misses for strike number two. Here now the 2-2. Will not catch the zone. Ball three.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at bat as this count now gets to 3 balls and 2 strikes.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And this is taken here for ball four. Just the second walk he's allowed into his eighth inning of work.
And when your pitch count gets over 100, you've got to expect them to lose a little bit of accuracy out there. And I think if he gets into any more trouble, they might come get him. We'll see if he can finish strong.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. Fourth trip to the plate now, and he's hitless to this point.
Yeah, he and his teammates have really been shut down by some very good pitching in this one. Been fun for a guy like me to watch.
Here's the first pitch to him. No balls and a strike to count. And low, it's a ball and a strike.
I'm seeing all the signs of fatigue right now. This is when you really have to bear down mentally as a pitcher.
Ball and two strikes now.
Classic change of speeds right there. Threw the hitter's timing off. Got a late foul ball. Interested to see where he goes now.
Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out.
In a double play situation,
you kind of expect most pitches to be down in the zone, hoping for a ground ball. So that was an interesting pitch selection to go up in the zone. I think he caught him off guard a little bit.
Here's Charlie Blackmon now. And this one's in the dirt. And a bad time for that as the runner takes second here. The 1-0 home down the first baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. And there's ball two now. A swing and a high pop-up. Aguilar over to his right. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. This one pretty well in the bag. Home half of the eighth straight ahead. The Brewers lead this one 6-0. Ready for another shot now. Jonathan Schoop. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Jonathan Schoop.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Laid off as it caught the inside corner. Now a right-hander has started to get loose in the Colorado bullpen. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. And that misses 1-1.
If you're going to have success against some of the better hitters in the game, you've got to get that pitch right there. 0-2, he's almost certainly out. 1-1, he's got a chance to really do some damage.
One and two now as that one's fouled off. The 1-2. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. The next 1-2 pitch. 1-2 pitch is a slider that misses 2-2.
That's a great take right there. Great pitch recognition to let that one go. Opposite handed, that's coming across the plate. You might think you got a shot to stay inside that one.
He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. And there's one well above the zone for a ball.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2. But when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
You can do it. All right, let's win, Brewer.
Oh, fastball swung on and missed. And for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
I really liked it. He gave up nibbling out of the zone trying to get him to chase. That wasn't working, so he just reached back and fired a good old country hardball fastball right by him. No better feeling in the world when you're a pitcher than throwing a fastball right by a guy.
Standing in now, Manny Pena. And a bouncing ball, foul. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Gonzalez giving chase. Lays himself out and makes a spectacular catch. Nope, sorry about that. They're saying it was short hop.
The right fielder, number 8, Ryan Braun.
Digging in now for the Brewers, Ryan Braun. He hit a two-bagger and later scored in his previous plate appearance.
You can do it, Ryan.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. 1-0. And a neck-high fastball that time. Pena, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Lays off again, and it's 2-0. Outside, 3-0 now. Set and a 3-0 offering. 3-0 fastballs in for a strike. The 3-1. And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with only one away.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count. The ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
Hernan Perez will get the call to pinch hit here, and he'll find he has a couple of runners aboard with only one out in the inning. From the belt, kicks and deals.
That's a ball.
And this one's downstairs. It's a ball and a strike. First and second now, one man out.
Let's go, Milwaukee. Yeah.
Slapped hard the opposite way, but he'll barely have to move out there and right as he hauls this one in for the second out. And he'll take those extra 90 feet, so put runners at the corners now with two gone in the inning.
Number six.
Sun Hwan-oh enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is.
Now pitching for the Rockies, number 18, Sun Hwan-oh.
Lorenzo Cain will be the first one to greet him now as he'll do so with runners at the corners and two out in the inning. From the stretch, and they'll start things out with a changeup here, but this is a bit too tight. It's ball one. Two and oh to the Brewers center fielder. Runners at the corners, two men out. Three and oh now. Pitch is a fastball taken on the inner half for a strike.
3-1 with 2-1, and this is where you got to be geared up for something to drive. I don't think you can just groove it one right here. You still have to try to make a competitive pitch.
Tapper up the line. He's got to hurry, and the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Brewers strand a couple. They lead it 6-0. Corey Knebel comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Corey Knebel.
Strike striding in to start the ninth, Nolan Arenado. And they'll need him to get something going here. First pitch coming. Here it is. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. Here comes the 0-1. And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. A 1-1 home. It is looked at for ball number two. Arenado swings, and this one is crushed out to left field. Yelich going back. Gone to lead off the inning. Nolan Arenado touches them all. His first homer so far in the series, and they're on the board at 6-1.
Well, they're not there yet, but a solo homer to lead off the inning will do wonders for any team's confidence. We'll see if the next few batters can continue the comeback effort here. Just need to string some good at-bats together now.
And that brings in the power-hitting shortstop, Trevor Story. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Set and the pitch. A cold strike on the inside corner. Action now in the Milwaukee bullpen as they'll have a right-hander loosen up. And he fouls this one off. Base is empty here with nobody out. Now a fastball here that'll wisely lay off, and it's 1-2. Swing on and miss. Really fooled him that time for the first out. Final line there for the Brewers starting pitcher. And he really delivered a fantastic postseason performance. Striding in for the Rockies, Ian Desmond. He flew out in his last at bat. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Skied into straightaway right. Braun has a read on it, and that's the second out of the inning. And that'll bring up the speedy outfielder David Dahl. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. First pitch of the at-bat. Just a bit high that time as he misses for a ball. Popped him up. Shaw on the move. And he tracks it down. And this ball game is over.
It's always nice to give your fans at home something to cheer about. And they definitely did that right here, coming through with a big win at home.
one more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. Brewers were given an excellent starting pitching performance from this man, Gio Gonzalez. Can't ask for much more. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he ended up handing things off to his bullpen buddies in the ninth, but still, eight strong innings from him really showed a lot in this one.
Six to one, the final tally today. Milwaukee jump out to a 1-0 series lead. Gio Gonzalez earns the victory on the mound. So that'll just about do it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com.